He is Associate Professor of Department of Civil.
Thank you, Madam. Good morning to everybody. Honorable Chairpersons and the NAMS for allowing me to come and present here. It's an honor. I was made member of the NAMS just a couple of years back, so this is my second visit. So what I'm going to talk about today is our work in yoga in the for schizophrenia, which we have been doing for the past several years. I will fail in my duty if I don't acknowledge the people who helped me in this, particularly my professor Gangadhar, who was the primary source of inspiration for this work. What I would be talking about is schizophrenia and its impact, why yoga, the particular study that I'm talking about, very briefly some additional work, and then try and summarize. I hope all the medical students recognize the importance of schizophrenia, which has a worldwide prevalence of nearly 1%, so that means nearly 1 crore people in India, and it's a very severe, possibly the most severe mental illness, and because its onset is in the primary time that we do our main work in our life, which is in the late teens and early adulthood. And the natural course, you can follow a rule of thirds, which basically says that one third improve reasonably, one third have episodes with some sort of residual deficits, and one third have a very poor course. And we all know that it causes tremendous burden, not only to the persons themselves, but also the family who have to care for these people. The current management is basically centered around antipsychotics, which are dopamine D2 blockers. And although there has been a revolution in pharmacotherapy for psychosis in the last 20 years, they still leave a lot to be desired. As you can see, we went from most of the initial discoveries or serendipitous discoveries that something worked for something else and therefore it would work in this illness. Later on, of course, we have designer molecules and novel molecules, and we have depot. But the problem is that they have come with their own significant side effects. The initial medications used to be called the conventional antipsychotic, used to make people very stiff, shaky and slow, produce a Parkinsonian syndrome. The later ones we thought that we had overcome that barrier, but unfortunately we now realize that they have metabolic complications and they make people stuffed, heavy and slow. So that's the progression in terms of side effects. And of course, there are also psychosocial managements as an add-on to pharmacology in schizophrenia, including family interventions and other related interventions, which is very resource intensive. In a country like India, it's very difficult. You don't even get a doctor to treat, where would you get all the other associated medical specialties? And of course, a lot of these people also use substances and have comorbidity. So why should we look at yoga? I think I'm standing in the right place today to talk about yoga, the spiritual center of India, Rishikesh. Possibly a fantastic coincidence that I've been selected for this NAMS. NAMSCON. So why we should look at it is there is already enough evidence that there is presence of significant depression and anxiety in these people with schizophrenia, and also cognitive and executive deficits. In fact, the cognitive and executive deficits are now being recognized in people much before they have clinical symptoms of schizophrenia. And on the other hand, if you look at it, yoga has significant proven benefits in all these areas, both in depression, anxiety, and as well as cognition. And as I already told you, there are significant limitations to current treatments of schizophrenia. So the so-called metabolic syndrome, which is very common in syndrome X, which is very common in the Indian population because of central obesity, worsens by the antipsychotics. And again, yoga has shown improvements in all these areas. So when we look at yogasana in schizophrenia, what we did is that it is the single largest trial of yoga for schizophrenia anywhere in the world up to date, which included 120 patients with schizophrenia. It's funded by the Department of Ayush and the Government of India. And innovations over any previous studies were that we added a waitlist control group, fairly large sample size for a study of this nature, and we added one unique instrument called for assessment of emotion recognition capability, which is a known problem for patients with schizophrenia. So this is just an outline of the study. We randomized people into three groups: yoga therapy, physical exercise and weightlift, and then trained them for 1 month in the yoga center at Nimhans and asked them to practice for 3 months and follow up after 4 months. So this is some of the assessments. The PANSS is a very commonly used positive and negative syndrome scale. It's the most common rating scale for schizophrenic symptoms. The second scale was developed at Demands to look at the social and occupational functioning of these people, real life functioning. And most of the other ones are so side effects, except this one. This last one here is the unique instrument which was again developed by one of our students at NIMHANS to recognize emotion recognition deficits. So the yoga group had a yoga package which lasted for 1 hour. This was developed in-house in collaboration with the S. Vyasa, which is a deemed university of yoga in Bangalore, the Swami Vivekananda Yoga Anusandhana Samsthana. So just a sample of some of the postures which were used in this. And the physical exercises, I hope all of us will remember doing it in school. The physical exercises, the same NCERT package we used as a control, taught by the same person for the same amount of time. So to get 120 patients, we had to screen nearly 1,000 patients. This is because people don't come to NIMHANS expecting to be taught yoga. They come to NIMHANS expecting to be given medicine. So we had to wait for a long time to get people. We got 120 people, out of which at the end of 4 months were able to follow up 95 of them. The majority of them were already on atypical antipsychotics and were comparable in the three groups at baseline. So this is the demographic variables at baseline. And what we did is we did assessments at baseline at the end of 4 months and looked at analysis using SPSS across three groups. So if you look at the results, the number of percentage of patients who improved in the three groups was clearly different. If you see here, this will make it a bit more clear. There was not much difference in what we call as the positive symptoms, which is delusions or hallucinations. But the real marked difference is what we call as the negative symptoms, which is basically amotivation, alogia. These people withdraw from society. They don't want to be involved in anything. That is more difficult to treat with medications, whereas positive symptoms, we have reasonably good medications, both older and newer ones. So this is really difficult to handle with medication, and that is the thing that seems to improve with yoga. So if you look at the odds ratio, the likelihood of improvement for the yoga group in terms of negative symptoms was about 5 times greater than both the other groups. Again, if you look at social functioning, because you have to make a link between social functioning and the negative symptoms, if a person doesn't even want to go out, he would be, you know, fairly impossible to function in both work or other social spheres. So as you can see, again, the yoga has a very clear role to play in improving social functioning. So this was the paper which was published, and the basis of which I have been selected for this award. And as a side note, when we looked at what happens to facial emotion recognition deficit, these are very important. It's basically, to explain it simply, it is the ability to recognize emotions in other people. Whether somebody is angry with you, whether somebody is happy with you, whether somebody is upset with you. These patients with schizophrenia have lose that ability, so their behavior looks abnormal to the other person. So they lose the ability to empathize with the other person, and therefore we measured what happens to this using trends. And again, this is a published paper out of that, where we showed that yoga seems to improve emotion recognition ability in people with schizophrenia. Now, it's all fine to say what happened, but how does it happen is also a very important question. This is the improvement in social cognition in people who did yoga. As you can see, it went up, whereas in the other people actually worsened. We think that it's possibly because the biological mediator may be oxytocin. I am sure all of you would have heard of oxytocin, which is what is called as the cuddle hormone, which is what promotes the bonding between mother and infant. We think that is involved because when you did yoga, the oxytocin went up significantly, did not so in the waitlist group. So we have written a review of schizophrenia covering most of these aspects, which makes things fairly clear. So if I were to summarize, I would say that yoga is better than exercise in outpatients. Both are better than waitlist in negative symptoms. Yoga also improves social cognition, and possibly oxytocin is a biological mediator. Now, what are the implications of this study? It's a fairly pragmatic study with sound methodology. Many trials include such clean sort of samples that it's not usable in the general public, but this is, you know, people coming to NIMHANS, and these are all on medication. And we were able to demonstrate benefits of a specific yoga module over and above medication effects. And particularly in people who have negative and cognitive symptoms which are difficult to treat. And we hopefully have opened new frontiers for the use of yoga in severe mental disorders. Because yoga for depression has been around for a long time, but yoga in psychosis is a fairly new concept in the last maybe decade. Of course, we do need long-term collaborative studies by yoga and medical professionals. And there are a lot of methodological issues in yoga, because what is yoga is a very difficult question to answer. It may be all or nothing. And of course, there are service delivery issues in rural population. Thank you.
Any questions? Yeah, please.
Excellent presentation, and quite a lot of work done there also.
Thank you, ma'am.
The question I have is that was the exercise group and the yoga group done as group activities, or were they individually done?
Group activities.
Both the exercise
both,
group
both,
also.
Both.
So that bias, otherwise, would be that they're meeting more people together.
Oh, yes. But it's exactly the same.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'm Dr. R.J. Singh. I must congratulate you for this nice vista that you have opened in the position of schizophrenia.
Thank you, sir.
At the same time, you know, yoga has got 8 components, as
Bhatmi,
starting from yam, niyam, asana, or pranayama. So, and diet plays a very important role. Did you concentrate on diet, whether they're all vegetarian, non-vegetarian, or they're falling number one? Second thing I know, mainly your package had only yogasana,
yes.
Third part of yoga, right?
Yes.
If you add with pranayama, which of course will have a lot of mental tranquility and other things. I mean, I'm sure in the next, I mean, once you're going to make grow, you add, apart from yogasana, add pranayama also.
Pranayama is there, sir. I have not shown it.
Achha, okay.
Because it is difficult to show
so many things.
But it is there, sir. The only thing that is not there is meditation, because it has been shown that meditation is a hyperdopaminergic state and can worsen psychosis. So meditation is, we have exclusively taken it out, but pranayama is there, sir. It's a very important component of the yogasana. What we have tried to do is make it fairly easy, so that any yoga therapist anywhere should be able to give the module, and we don't have copyright on that module. We give it freely to anybody who asks it. We print it and give it so that people get the benefit. But pranayama is there. I think it's very important. If I would answer your first question, yam niyam is important, but it's very difficult to evaluate. Diet, we have the data, I have not presented it here. Predominantly, they were vegetarian. Predominantly, but then vegetarian itself can have so many components. Studying that is very difficult, sir. But it's a good question.
Your study is a randomized study.
Yes, sir.
So what was the exclusion criteria? Because you said that all the schizophrenic patients, you identified 900 plus.
Yes.
Then you randomized 120, and follow-up was for 95 patients.
Yes.
What was the exclusion criteria in those schizophrenic patients?
No, the 95 dropped out. They didn't come for follow-up. We couldn't get them for follow-up. So it's not that they were excluded. The exclusion criteria were age. Very old people or very young children we didn't take.
Because my question is pertaining to the comorbidities associated with schizophrenia and
right.
You are exposing to yoga. That
yes.
is my question.
The exclusion criteria were mainly substance abuse, alcohol and other things, because they can impact a lot of these things. But nicotine we have included, because it has to be fairly pragmatic. Otherwise, if you take people who don't smoke, don't do any other thing, it will not be useful to the general public. A lot of people with schizophrenia smoke. So the only main exclusion criteria was age and alcoholism or degenerative neurological disorders, Parkinson's and other things.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, madam.
Sir, I want to ask that for doing yoga, we need a setup of mind that we want to do it. And in patient of schizophrenia who have negative symptoms like depression and anxiety, how do you convince all these patients to do yoga in a group exercise? I want to know that how you started this study.
I think you hit the nail on the head, madam. I think you are the person who got the award yesterday, so I can see you are very interested. But what that's why till 2000 there was not a single paper on yoga and psychosis. Many people thought that these people are not capable of doing yoga or not interested in doing yoga, but you would be surprised, madam, that if you come to the Nimens Yoga Center every day, the single largest session is yoga for psychosis. There are at least 20 patients each day who come, and we have to separate them into groups because we don't have space. Whereas the other things, the anxiety, the depression, we would think that they would come, they drop out. Now these people are so desperate to get better that they will come, and the families will bring them. So I don't think it's very difficult.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry?
Yes, sir.
Actually, sir, I wanted to know that what is more beneficial here, means pranayam or asanas?
It would be difficult to tell you without dissecting the study further. What we have done is try to make a fairly integrated module which has possibly 50-50 of both. But if you are specific to mental effects, I think it would be the pranayam. It would be more important to look at the breathing rather than the asana, because they have more mental effects.
Sir, were the patients continuing their medications also?
Oh yes. In schizophrenia, I don't think there's a chance that they could stop taking medication. In depression, that could happen, that yoga could be a sole treatment. We have done that as well. But not in schizophrenia. They would need antipsychotics, although the dose might reduce because they're doing yoga. But they do need medication, yes.
Thank you, sir, for bringing this to me.
I also have a question.
Yes, madam.
Rather, two questions and one comment.
Yes, madam.
How many dropouts were there and how did you ensure compliance?
25 dropouts out of the 120 in terms of 4 months.
All the groups?
Including all the groups. All the groups. The major dropout was females in physical exercise. And we asked the question in the end why. They said it doesn't suit us to come and jog and those things, so they simply refuse to come for the physical exercise, and I don't think they do it at home as well. So it's a very difficult thing for ladies. They have to change their dress, they have to wear track pants or something or the other, come jogging, and they feel it's fairly silly that you are making us do this as a treatment. So that is a main dropout rate. The second question is that how do you ensure compliance at home is a very difficult thing. What we did, of course, is that we telephone contact and a diary to mark, but even then that was marked by the relative.
Yeah.
How accurate it is very difficult to do. That's one of the limitations.
Yeah. And I have a comment.
Yes, madam.
If you had done those good hormones, the positive emotional hormones like oxytocin is one of them, it would have added much to your work.
Yes,
did you
ma'am.
Do those?
Oxytocin we did in a later study, not in the study that I have got the award for. No.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Can you do the
results
then?
Sir? Yes, the yoga increased the oxytocin significantly. That is, we think that is behind the social cognition improvement.
And the exercise did not?
Not, no.
Thank you. We request you to kindly receive the Dr. Vimla Varmani Award, Dr. Shivaram Varambali.